process for integrating advanced reports and dashboards into the Web HMI is straightforward and well documented. I have my system guide open to the page Configure, Distributed Systems, Advanced Reporting and Dashboard Server, Add Advanced Dashboards and Reports into Web Applications, and I'll follow the procedure listed here. The first step is to enable single sign-on between the two applications. This allows me to access the AR applications using a single username and password. We've already configured a user in our project, so I just need to configure the AR user. Note that I am using the full Power Monitoring Expert package here, but the process is identical for advanced reports. In the web applications, I'll navigate to Settings, Users, User Manager. If I'm using a standard SciTech user, as we have been, I can add a standard user with the same username and password. I'll refer you to the Help link in the top left for more information on user privileges. I'll need to do this for each user in my project that I want to give access to advanced reports. However, if I'm using a Windows group to manage my users, I can add the same group to AR for the same effect. While I'm here, if Advanced Reports is running on a different machine, I'll need to tell it to allow the Web HMI to host it. Under the Settings menu, I'll navigate to Security, Authorized Hosts. In this Hosts That Can Frame field, I'll add https://myservername and click Add. If I have a standby server, I'll add that as well. Now that Advanced Reports is configured, I need to tell my web server where to find it. There are two files to configure in the folder, C drive, Program Files x86, Schneider Electric, PowerSCADA Operation, the version name, Applications, Web, System Data Service, App Data, Configuration. I know that's a mouthful. The first file is hmiconfiguration.json. This tells the server where Advanced Reports lives and needs to be configured whether AR is on the same server or not. If this file doesn't exist, you need to run the Web HMI once to create it automatically. Copy the first JSON object from the system guide and paste it inside the entries list, making sure to add a comma after the first entry. We only need to change Advanced Reports URL to the full server name. In this case, https://server. Save and close this file. Next, we'll add the Reports tab to the Web HMI in the file application-menu-config.json. As before, copy the second JSON block out of the system guide, but we need to paste this in a specific location inside this file. The first array here is called Application Settings, and this contains our menu in order. At the end, I can see the Trends button, so let me add a comma and paste in my new menu entry. Be sure not to scroll down and paste in one of the other objects. I need to edit the fields in this object. ID needs to be a unique identifier for the tab with no spaces. Description is a useful description of the tab. while display name is the actual name that shows up in the web HMI menu. Finally, I'll copy the target out of the system guide. This is the URL for the application I want to view. At this point, I can save, close, and refresh the web HMI. My new tab automatically shows up, and it will log me into Advanced Reports. I'll go ahead and do the same thing for dashboards, and in the next video, we'll build a simple dashboard. Until then, thank you.